It's me. It's Camm. Heart of Down culture.
There we go.
I'm here. Rocking out.
Yeah, you guys did an amazing job.
Thank you. Yeah, that was crazy. Like, we haven't played a show like that in Chicago, I don't think, ever.
Ever?
Like, we played shows in Chicago, but not like that.
Okay.
That was nuts.
How many times have you been to Chicago?
I want to say three.
Three times?
Yeah, I want to say three.
Very cool.
Yeah.
So, personally, I don't know a lot about Down with Webster, so you're going to have to educate me.
Hey, fair enough.
Okay, so tell me, how did it all start?
It started a very long time ago as, you know, us as kids, kind of. We all met in junior high, like, around 11, 12 years old, and, like, the band in its first stages was just, like, it was just fun. It was stuff that we did after school, and you know, in high school, we began to play shows for our friends and, you know, write and record songs and sort of play them at our own parties and do that kind of stuff. And then, you know, when everyone was sort of about to go off to college, you know, everybody kind of went, we're going to take this seriously, we want to do this for a living. And then, luckily enough, we got signed, like, 2 years later, and kind of blew up in Canada, and it's been really good to us, and, you know, doing it big up there, and now we're just, like, on a mission to kind of come down here and spread it.
Okay. So, you guys are big in Canada, and now you're making your way into the U.S.
Yeah.
How is the U.S. response so far?
Amazing. Like, you saw that. It was nuts. It was, like, I find it very similar, like, because they're different countries, people tend to feel, I think, that, like, they're vastly different people, but it's all the same music, it's the same culture, it's the same stuff, especially where we're from in Toronto, which is basically, like, it feels like Chicago or another American city, except the money's weird color. Yeah, that's about it.
So, describe your guys' sound.
It's tough. It's like we kind of borrow from everything. Like there's guys in our group that, you know, are super into electronic. There's guys like me, I'm super into rap. There's guys that are really into rock. You know, Tyler and Marty grew up playing jazz and their dad's a wedding band and stuff. So, you know, it's definitely been a mission to try and rein it in and figure out what it is that we do and what we want to sound like. But we don't think about it that hard. It just sort of, it happens. And it's partially due to the fact that we've been a band for so long that, like, we've had a lot of time to sort of tinker and figure out what we want to do.
Okay, so you guys haven't been really, like, when it comes to recording, you guys haven't really classed on it because you guys have so many different genres.
Yeah, and it's more like someone will bring something to the table, and if everyone likes it, and we're like, you know what I mean, we're pretty open-minded, and if everyone likes it, then we're like, yeah, let's roll with it.
Okay. Now, what personally got you into music?
Me, just like I was obsessed with listening to music. I think that's how most people start off. I would assume that they're fans of music, and like, you know, I had always had headphones on and was just like that kid who was like super into it. And then I got to a certain point and I realized I'm like, I can do this. This is something that I want to do, and it's something that I started doing just for fun in my spare time. And I was like, this is all I want to do. I'd be working, like, you know, my job at the grocery store at 16 years old, and like all I would be thinking about is like song lyrics and ideas, and I'd be like, this is what I want to do.
Now, you said you're really into rap.
Yeah.
What artists influenced you?
Oh, like it's tough to tell because it's like I'm probably influenced by everything that I've listened to, but it's like, you know, growing up at my most impressionable ages when I was like really young was probably like the 90s. Like I started listening to rap pretty young. And younger than my parents probably wanted me to. They hated it. But, you know, like Wu-Tang Clan, Busta Rhymes, I was really into, again, it's not rap, but I was into Rage Against the Machine and Cypress Hill and all that stuff. But even nowadays, like, I pretty much listen to everything that comes out. I'm just, like, an enormous consumer of hip-hop music.
Very cool. Now, tell us a little bit about your record. It came out this year, correct?
Yeah, actually. It came out in Canada in January, and then it came out here, like, only
ago or something.
Pretty big delay, which next time we're not gonna do. Yeah.
Good.
Yeah. It was some weird shit with the label.
Okay, got it. So I'm guessing the response in Canada was great.
Yeah, it was awesome. Like, yeah, we get, like, you know, big radio play and stuff like that. Like, they show us so much love up there. It's amazing.
That's awesome.
And then, like, people in the States are, like, they're just learning about it now, but, like, the response is incredible. Like, my Twitter and stuff, R&D shows, it's like, it's nuts.
So you guys are currently on tour with Time Flies.
Yeah.
How is that going, by the way?
Amazing. Time Flies are like the nicest dudes. Like, you never, like, I didn't know them previous to this tour, so it was kind of like, you never know what you're getting into, kind of. You're like, what are these people going to be like? We have to, like, live on the road with them for a month. Mm-hmm. And within the first 2 days, like, obviously the nicest guys ever. So, like, great, great people to mess with. Them and Capslap, he's, like, he's traveling with us, like, in our van. Amazing. Amazing people.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So, where are you guys going right after Chicago?
Right after Chicago, we actually have a day off in Chicago tomorrow, which is going to be amazing. Looking forward to that. And then Madison, Wisconsin. That's nice.
Are there any cities in particular you're excited to play in?
I always like California, mm-hmm. partially because I'm from such a cold place that I like going down. It's like different for me, so
yeah.
I like that. And always excited to play New York. I have a lot of family out there, so that's always fun.
So life on the tour, tell us a little bit about that. So you said you only got like an hour of sleep.
I did that to myself, yeah. Sometimes, you know, you gotta pick your moments, and sometimes those moments happen right before a big show. Okay. Yeah, staying out to all hours. It's nonsense.
So, I checked out a couple of your music videos
mm-hmm.
online. So
nice.
Tell us about your most recent one and what making that music video.
The most recent one was Chills, and it was actually our friend who shoots a lot of our stuff, this guy Aaron A. And he wanted to do this, he had this crazy idea where he wanted to like project images of people's faces onto their hands like this, and I was like, what are you talking about? I have no idea, it sounded crazy. And then he showed me what he's talking about, and I'm like, oh, that looks crazy. It's like some like optical illusion stuff. So it was pretty easy. Like it was a lot of like still, like it was all done in the studio. As far as videos go, it was pretty easy to shoot, and it ended up looking cool.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
God, I'm so sorry. Cap.
I can't do this.
Wait, since we're still doing this, can I grab that real quick?
Which one? this iron brick?
Yeah, the
big. Oh
no.
I'm so sorry. I forgot about this.
I'm not editing.
You cut that. Not editing.
He's such
perfect.
An
angel. You guys are great.
He cast the best. Yes.
Might as well.
Might as well.
So you said you played here in Chicago before.
Yeah.
Are there any spots in Chicago you like to go to? I don't know if you've ever had a day off
before. No, we've never had a day off here. It's always been like play the show, pack up, go. So sort of been a look around, tell more, and hopefully find some spots.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. Now, just so fans can get to know you a little bit more, name five things you always have to bring on tour with you.
Five things that I always have to. See, but a lot of these are going to be like self-explanatory. Like, I have to have headphones. I can't, obviously, I can't go anywhere without headphones. Have to have my laptop. Can't go anywhere without the laptop because that's where I do music when I'm on the road. That's how we write and keep up with that. A lot of socks. Socks are important. You don't want dirty laundry on the road, especially when you're traveling with people and like laundry's piling up. So I just like go to Walmart and buy so many socks, and then when I'm done every day, I just throw them out because it's easier than, you know, keeping a bag of dirty socks, which you don't want. So what's that?
That's
three. I need two more. Red Bull. I survive off Red Bull. I'm not a coffee drinker, so I just like go hard on Red Bull. They're nice enough that they usually hook us up, so we just grab some cases off them before we go. It keeps me alive. Let's see. Number five. What else do I have to bring on the road? I don't know. I think I pretty much, those are my essentials. Like everything else is like, I don't know, my cell phone. It helps to have a cell phone.
Yeah. Underwear.
Basic stuff that everyone brings to like tour or not, you know?
I've had someone bring a stuffed animal. They have to bring a stuffed animal.
Really?
Yeah, it's very sentimental.
Wow. Okay,
yeah.
No. I don't have anything like that.
All right. And have there been any crazy tour stories? Any?
Yeah,
updates?
Like, you know, there has been, but it's best not to always delve into those, you know?
Have you done any pranks?
No, not yet. Again, like, we just sort of, like, met 7 days ago, so this has been, like, getting to know each other and, like...
Well, past tours.
Feeling, oh, yeah, past tours. We've done tons of pranks. We put all these live lobsters on stage once, and everyone was freaking out because the singer and the other band hated them, like, was, like, phobic of them. We, like, freaked out. Trying to think any other good stuff. Just, like, a lot of, like dumb shit. Like, putting baby powder in people's bunks. Like, a lot of baby powder. When they crawl in, it just goes, and, like... goes everywhere and they can't get it out. trying to think. Yeah, it's like dumb stuff like that.
Alright, so well, we're gonna wrap things up, bud.
Right.
What is a message you would love for your fans to know?
Message for my fans to know? New music is on the way. As soon as we're done this tour, we're straight to LA, in the studio, working on our next EP that hopefully is gonna be out, like, pretty shortly. So, you know, new music, new videos, watch for us. It's gonna be a productive year.
Alright, awesome. Thank you so much, really appreciate
hey,
it.
Thank you.
Always a pleasure.
Hey. You know it. Cool every